गुड आफ्टरनून एंड नमस्ते एवरीबॉडी बुद्ध टेलीविजन व्यूअर्स. टुडे आई रिक्वेस्ट गार्जियंस टू मैनेज टाइम एंड वॉच बुद्ध टेलीविजन प्रोग्राम्स क्लासरूम क्लासेज टू देयर स्टूडेंट्स एंड प्लीज टेक केयर ऑफ योर चिल्ड्रन इफ दे आर वॉचिंग और वेस्टिंग टाइम. If they are chatting necessarily or unnecessarily, please sit behind them and encourage them. Now, I want to revise the previous topic. In the previous class, I taught my students about connectives. There are some matters, some important matters were remained about connectives. Some students asked me how to compare in spite of and in spite of the fact that. Some students asked me how to compare because and therefore. Now I am supporting you for some time. Then we'll start next topic today. Listen to my students. Because comes before reason sentence. Because comes before reason sentence. But therefore comes before result sentence. One comes before reason and another comes before result. They are just opposite. Be careful. These two sentence connectives are opposite connectives. One comes before reason sentence and another comes before result sentence. Therefore and so they are similar. Because, as, since, they are similar. In the previous class, we compared, we studied the similarities and differences. Now, we are comparing because with therefore. Let's see one short example. He is dull. Okay, he is dull he can't pass the test. Very short example. Okay, first one is reason. Being dull is reason. And what is the result? Failing the test. This is result, and this result must be expected. In the previous class, I repeatedly told you, suggested you, don't forget. Okay? If you join using because, first write here result. He can't pass the test because he is dull. See, he can't pass the test because he is dull. After writing because, write reason sentence again. And because never comes in the beginning, it will not be suitable. Some use because in the beginning, but it does not seem to be suitable because generally comes in the middle. And therefore also comes in the middle, and it is just opposite. How? See, he is dull, so or therefore, then use comma, After because comma does not come. After, so or therefore generally we use comma. He is dull, so therefore he can't pass the test. Right, full sentence. We do not have to reform. We do not have to change. We can use whole sentence. But we have to remember what comes first or what comes next. Here, result, region, look at my finger. Result, then region. Here, region, then result. Later you will see some slides also. And remember this much difference for today. And next one, some grade 10 students, see, asked me about this. He stood first. He was attentive in his study. Here, in this pair, he stood first is result. First one is result, second one is region. Look at the statement there, how I have joined. Because he was attentive in his study. Remember, because comes before reason sentence, so therefore come before result sentence. You have watched on screen too. Now see another example, another pair on the board. Another one is although, even though. In spite of, despite, in spite of the fact that in the previous class I had no time to talk about, in spite of the fact that. So some students phoned me, now I am trying to clear you. You knew about it. It comes before reason. Reason sentence. It comes before reason NP. It also comes before reason sentence. In this sense, although and in spite of the fact that are similar. In spite of is different, it takes NP. In spite of the fact that, and although, even though, they are same. Look at the arrow, they are same. Okay, they are same. Look at the arrow. Now, see the example. He is dull. He can pass the test. The pair is unexpected pair. Such unexpected pair, to join such unexpected pair, we use although, even though. Although he is dull, comma, he can pass the test. Okay? Although he is dull, he can pass the test. Another example. Look at the another example. In spite of his dullness. In spite of his dullness, he can pass the test here after in spite of dullness NP. But in spite of the fact that in spite of the fact that he is dull again, he can pass the test. Compare please. Although take sentence, in spite of the fact that also take sentence, but in spite of takes NP. This is the difference. Now you will see the slide about this comparison. See the slide. Everybody, see the slide. Although, though, even though, in spite of and despite. My grandfather is very active, although he is 85 years old. Look at the answer. How I have joined there. See, what is the difference? Although, though, even though. Although comes, even though comes before sentence, in spite of, despite comes before NP, but in spite of the fact that takes again sentence. Now, I think you are clear about this. Again, there are some connectives which are called purpose connectives. They are to, in order to, so that, and FOR for. They come before V1, plural verb. I say V1, V1 is plural verb. Just like go, come, first verb. Second verb is V2, in short I say. Past participle verb is V3, I say. Progressive verb, ing verb is V4. Singular verb, goes, writes, that is V5. Remember, V1, V2, V3, V4, V5 also, not to be in confusion. And so that takes sentence. What type of sentence? Subject with can, could. This type of sentence comes. And for takes ing form or NP form or NP then to V1 form, which is called to infinitive also. Okay. Now, how we joined? I went to a bank. I went to a bank. I wanted to cash my check. Yeah, I wrote CHECK check. American people use CHECK check. Okay. British people use CHEQUE. Don't forget about the spelling. I wrote the CHECK check. And here, first one is activity or action. Second one is purpose. See, okay? And we use to in order to, so that for before purpose. How? I went to a bank to or in order to, then V1. Cash, remove it, use cash, cash my check, to cash my check or in order to cash my check. Similarly, if you want to use so that, I went to a bank so that I could, past could, present can. I could cash my check. Okay? If you want to use, if you want to use for, I went to a bank for cashing, ing form, for cashing my check. This way we join, and again remember, so that and F or for, they come only in the middle, they never come in the beginning. Generally, we don't use in the beginning, but to and in order to, they come either in the beginning or in the middle. This matter was remained in the previous class. Now, you can see the remaining slides. You can see the remaining slides about TO2, in order to, so that, and for. Please, read them. How I have joined. And you can copy if necessary. You can copy if necessary. He went to a bank to cash his check. CHECK check or CHEQUE. You should not indulge in pronunciation and spelling, because there are different two poles and they have brought us confusion. Even writing spelling, COLOR color, COLOUR color, or BOY boy, BOY boy, DIRECT direct, DIRECT direct. They are indulging us, but we should not indulge in it. Now, I think you are clear about it. Okay? And now, next slide. See, next slide. There is some comparison. See? This is also about FOR for. How it is joined? For dear children to look at it. For plus NP plus 2B1. Another? For family. In this structure, FOR for may be connective, for may be preposition. In another example, for is fully period of time. It may be past period of time, it may be future period of time. We have been living in Butuwal for years, that is past period of time. We will be living in Butuwal for years, it will be or it is future period of time. How we form? In the previous class you learnt how to form NP. And now, how to make period of time? In the next slide, please view. Next slide about period of time. A day, 2 days, 3 days, 100 days, this way. Decade, century, millennium, fortnight. Fortnight is 2 weeks period. 15 days is called fortnight. Seconds, seconds, years, several, many. Okay? Hour, hours, these are period of time. And period of time is to be understood, to be recognized, to use FOR for. Because in grade 11 also, there is the comparison or exercise about for, since, in, at. Sometimes you have to create short dialogue, conversation, sometimes you have to fill up the blanks. And even in grade 12, there is FOR for, that is activity. You learn activity and achievement. Activity, period of time, that is FOR for. Achievement, period of time, that is ion in. Activity point of time, that is until, and achievement point of time, that is what is called for, in, until, by. Achievement point of time, that is by. There is comparison until, by, for, in. For grade 12 students also, they need what is period of time and how we have to use FR4. See, next one, next slide. See, next slide. Grade 10 students, the question comes this way. You have to fill the blanks. This is last question. SEC model, last question. There is a paragraph. The paragraph comes in the last question. And you have to fill the blank this way. Grade 11 students, the question comes this way. Okay? Period of time, point of time. And grade 12 students, they have to tackle the question this way using how long. Okay? You can see the next slide. View next slide. Grade 12, how long question? They talked on the telephone, 10 minutes. That is period of time activity. Period of time activity, that is FR4. Period of time means you saw, you watched. Activity means incomplete action is called activity. Complete action is called achievement. For how long they talked? It is not clear. So it is activity. And 10 minutes, minute, second, hour, that is period of time. How long did they talk on the telephone? They talked on the telephone for 10 minutes. In this exercise, you learn how to use spend and take. But when you learn spend and take, you do not have to use for since. You do not have to use by in until. Okay? This type of examples are not brought here because mainly the class is concentrated to grade 10 SEE takers mainly. And grade 11, 12 students also can take much more benefits. Below, this last exercise, I wrote the examples. It shows the difference among, although in spite of the fact that it is given in unit 24, grade 11. Okay? Very important exercise. Although takes sentence, in spite of takes NP, in spite of the fact that takes again sentence. Okay. This much for topic connective. Now, I want to take permission from you to change the topic. And today's another topic is voice. I tried to sum up the previous class. The matter that were remained, that I wanted to solve in front of you, but I was unable to solve due to the lack of time. And I tried to solve in the previous time. Now, please listen about voice. Before changing voice, in Nepali there are three types of voices. Voice is bacha. Kartivacha, karma vacha, bhav vacha, if I am not wrong. But in Nepali, there are two types only, active voice and passive voice. For the examination viewpoint, you have to learn how to change active from passive or from passive to active. Sometimes, what happens? You have to also learn which structure can be changed and which structure cannot be changed for knowledge viewpoint, not for the examination viewpoint. For those students who require advanced knowledge, who require greater knowledge, it will be fruitful for them mainly. And for middle students, they only know how to change. And again, I request my students, please, knowledge is that sort of element which can be transferred from one person to another person. So, you have to learn with reason, as possible. You learn and you guide your brothers, sisters. Senior brothers, sisters can guide your junior brothers and sisters. if he watch carefully. There are some differences that can be changed, that cannot be changed, first of all. Number two, which structures have to be concentrated here? Number three, if we cannot change, why? And number four, if we can change, how? I am trying to pay my concentration on these subtopics here first. In the sense of voice, okay? First of all, you have to recognize assertive. Assertive is beginning with subject. And again, remember, my dear students, in the sense of voice, subject must be NP. Object must be NP. Otherwise, we cannot change into passive nor active. NP, either you say noun phrase or you say noun pronoun, that comes before verb is subject. NP, that comes after verb is object. Otherwise, we cannot change into passive because we have to change the space. First, object comes, look at number. Object comes in the place of subject, number one. Then number two, you have to change verb. How do you change verb? You can see, you can watch, don't worry. And third, subject goes in the place of object, sometimes by, or generally by, but sometimes we use other appropriate prepositions, not always by. Sometimes other preposition that verb takes. Okay? If time allows, we'll try to define, to practice on the board. If not, you can see the slide. Okay? You can see the slide. First of all, assertive. I think you are able to recognize. You are able to recognize. Number two, imperative. See the slides. In imperative, there is no subject. Another is command without subject. In imperative, command, negative command, request form and late form. These are called imperative. Then comes interrogative. Number three is interrogative. Interrogative is question. Interrogative is question. Next slide, interrogative. Okay? In interrogative, there are two types, SNO question and WH question. Remember, you have to understand how to change SNO question, how to change WH question, how to change command, how to change assertive. First, number one, you are clear about assertive, imperative, and interrogative. We are not talking about optative and exclamatory here. Generally, for grade 9, 10, grade 11, and grade 12. Optative and exclamatory sentences are not asked to change into either active or passive. Now, you are clear about structure that we require for voice. Then, number two, look at the board. Look at the board. I am writing here. Some sentences cannot be changed. Previously, I told you. What are they? No voice, okay, or no passive, no voice, better to say. If there is only be verb, in your sentence, I am a boy, this type of sentence cannot be changed into passive. Remember, number two, present perfect continuous, have has been before, cannot be changed. Next, past perfect continuous, for example, had been before, cannot be changed. Another, I am writing here, I am rubbing this, future continuous. future continuous. For example, shall, will, be, before. We cannot change. Another, I am robbing. Please, if you need, you can copy. Otherwise, you will see later. I am robbing it. There is no space. Okay. Another, future perfect continuous. For example, shall, will, have been, before. These tenses cannot be changed, and used to be one. Used to be one. It is in grade 11. Be used to before. It is in grade 12. This structure also cannot be changed. Remember, and the most important thing is, if there is, okay, if there is intransitive verb, if there is intransitive verb, we cannot change voice. And what is transitive, what is intransitive, it comes later. Okay, now what can be changed then? What can be changed? See, what can be changed? Number one, simple present. Shortcut V1, V5. Number two, present continuous. Shortcut M is R, V4. See, board. I am writing quickly. I am not paying concentration on my handwriting. I am paying concentration on my matter. My students know it. Simple present, present continuous, present perfect. For example, have, has, V3. How many tenses? I wrote 1, 2, 3. Another, past perfect, that is had V3, okay. Another, past continuous, for example, was, were, before, simple present, present continuous, present perfect. Another is simple past. I am writing here simple past. That is V2. How many tenses I wrote? I wrote simple present. In present, simple present, present continuous, present perfect. Three tenses. In past, simple past, past continuous, and past perfect. Now about future. About future. About future, two tenses. One is modal V1, shall, should, will, would, can, could, V1. Okay. Shall, should, will, would, can, could, may, might, must, or to. Remember, there are 10 verbs which are called modal. Okay? Modal V1, another. Modal have V3. Will have V3. Would have V3. This way. And another is be going to V1. Remember, these tenses can be changed into passive. But again, remember, these tenses also must have transitive verb. Otherwise, we cannot change into passive. No tense can be changed into passive if there is intransitive verb. Okay? Now, the point comes. The point comes. What is transitive and what is intransitive. Then you will see some slides later. See, the same verb may be transitive or intransitive, and sometimes some verbs are always intransitive. For example, I go home. This is intransitive verb. We cannot change into passive. Okay, he works hard. It is intransitive. How? Because there is no NP. Home is not NP. This is place adverbial. Okay, he works hard. Hard is not NP. This is adverb. Adverb denotes activity. Okay, place adverbial denotes place. Time adverbial denotes time. Okay, these are not NPs. These are not NPs, and these are neither subject nor object. If the verb has no relation, I have crossed there, no relation with object, or if the verb has no object, this verb is intransitive, shortcut INT verb. You can see in your grammar, this verb cannot be changed into passive. This verb cannot be changed into passive because these are intransitive verb. Whatever tense may be, it does not matter. But recognize first if there is transitive verb or intransitive verb. Otherwise, you will fail. Some guardians, some friends may ask you simple question. Hello, boy, in which class do you read? I read in class 10. Can you change he works hard into passive? Some may ask. So you have to be sure, you have to be confident that intransitive verb cannot be changed. This way, if you answer, then your learning will be great. Okay? And what can be changed? Transitive verb. How do you recognize? He wrote beautifully. Again, see, I'm comparing. The same verb may or may not be transitive or intransitive. Okay? He wrote beautifully. He wrote a letter beautifully. Okay? Compare. Here, after verb, there is adverb. Verb has no relation with object. There is no object. Adverb is not object. Adjective, adverb, time clause, place adverbial, they are not object in the sense of voice. Be careful. Only in the sense of voice. Okay? And here, this is verb intransitive, INTV. This is verb transitive, VT. Generally, we write in short this way, INTV or VT. This is short form, short written technique. Okay? When you say INTV, that is intransitive verb. Why? Because there is no NP after verb, there is adverb. And we cannot change this kind of sentence into passive, whatever tense may be. But this can be changed into passive because there is NP. There is NP. And how we change? Previously, I suggested you. First, this NP comes, okay? Object becomes subject or new subject. Way to change. Okay? How do you change? First, recognize object. If you fail to recognize object, you fail to change into passive. Your beginning will be wrong. Okay? Then second step, change the verb. Change the verb. And third step, your subject. Subject, okay, becomes object or new object, whatever you say, whatever you suppose. So, in this way, you change. Remember the three steps. Okay? First, you learnt how to recognize sentence. Then, you learnt which sentences can be changed. Then, you learnt which sentences cannot be changed and why. And then, you learnt how to change steps. Up to there, you learnt three things. Remember? Then, now, watch, view some slides that I have brought. Okay? See, some slides. Please, slides. Students. Look at the slides. That cannot be changed. I wrote on the board, and now you can view there also. That can be changed. That cannot be changed at a glance. Okay. I have brought so many matters. Please have a glance, quick look. This is your revision class. Some new grade 10 students may not have clear concept. I have to say sorry for old grade 10, grade 11 and grade 12. They can understand very clearly because they have repeatedly studied in their classroom too. Okay? Now, what to change? What to not change? Second one, second slide. Note, the verb which has object, that is transitive, which has no object, that is intransitive. Previously I suggested you, it is enough. Now, next one, next matter, view next matter, okay? Steps, these steps, you are clearly understood. First one, recognize object and use in the place of subject. Then, change verb. How do we have to change verb? It comes. Gradually it comes, don't worry. And third, object goes in the place. Subject goes in the place of object. These are three steps. Sometimes we use by, okay? Sometimes we use other prepositions. Okay. Now let's see. Okay. Yesterday Ram killed a boar in the forest. Here, yesterday is time clause, it is not subject. Ram is subject, killed is verb, a bird is object, in the forest is not object. So yesterday in the same place, I replaced a bird in the subject and killed is V2, V2 changes into was or V3. Okay. Then in the forest and by Ram. Yesterday a bird was killed in the forest by Ram. She takes the exam frequently. The exam is taken frequently. Here takes is present verb. Present verb changes into MER V3. Past verb changes into was were V3. Present verb changes into MER V3. Okay. Another is modal V1. Modal V1 changes into modal B V3. There is phrasal verb also. Must go. That is modal V1. Go into, that is phrasal verb. Verb plus preposition to have a new meaning. For example, look after, look for, these are called phrasal verbs and use at the same place. This matter must be gone into. And sometimes you may have single object, sometimes you may have double object. She told me a story. Here, me is indirect object, a story is direct object. A story is retained object in this sense. Okay? In this sense, story is retained object, but below I was told a story. Another answer, a story was told to me. In this sense, to me is retained object. In the above, a story is retained object, below to me is retained object. There are double two objects, so you have two answers. But below, people elected him MP. Him refers to MP, MP refers to him, so there is single object and you have single answer. He was elected MP, but you cannot say MP was elected to him. If you say this way, it will be wrong. We suppose that is wrong because indirect object, him, comes in the place of subject, he was elected MP. Single object and single answer. Remember, sometimes we use by, sometimes we don't use by. Previously also I tried to facilitate you. Now change the slide. See, sometimes we use to. If there is verb no, oblige, marry, we use to instead of by. Sometimes we use with. If there is verb satisfy, dissatisfy, please, displeases, this way. If there is interest, we use in. If there is astonish, surprise, shock, we use at. If there is frightened, we use at or with. If there is bury, we use in or under. Example, all know Kalidas. Kalidas is known to all, not by all, to all. Similarly, if there is satisfied, dissatisfied, we use with. There is no sentence, you can listen. For example, the decision satisfied me. I was satisfied with the decision. This way, I have brought so many matters, but our technician informed me time is getting over. So if time allows, we will see, we will enjoy the class in the next period. Today, I say thanks everybody, thanks a lot. And especially my thanks goes to Buddha Community Television family who provided me such opportunity. Thank you. Thanks a lot.